If I was a bad person, I could have taken the price tag off of that. They may need to rethink that. Somebody could just, you know, get a nice necklace and take the tag off. Don't get any ideas, because don't be evil. Who would steal from a church-run organization? Boy, there's a whole nother hell for those people. Just saying. Hi! Happy Hoarder here. And I did hit the hills this weekend, Saturday. My sister was in town, and so we're like, oh, what do we want to do? And so we decided we'd run over there for a few minutes, and I stayed probably an hour. But I found some cool stuff. And she bought nothing. I don't know. She didn't need to shop there. But I am wearing some my favorite Rolling Hills stuff. This is one of those Florida leads. It just clips on to your necklace. And so it's just, this is like one of my son's old necklaces. Used to have a shark tooth on it. So yeah, something to do. And then this is a really cool linen top by, I think this is Match Point. And then I just have this longer gray skirt and the pants I bought the other day, my little tight pants. And they actually fit, so I'm happy about that. Well, so I didn't buy a lot of stuff. I went for clothes this time. And I found something I would never buy in a store. I should entitle this, I would never buy this in a store. In fact, that's what I'm going to put on the title. I like that. It's by Massimo. I don't know how to pronounce them. I need to look that up. And it's super, 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 super soft flannel. But it's got these ruffles in the back and then ruffles in the front. And I just said, you know, it's so different. And I love the color. Actually, kind of cool color to be cute with jeans. And so I thought, I'm going to try it on. It's pretty cute. It is. It's just kind of funny looking. Maybe I'll wear it one day for a video. But yes, it turned out to be a really fun little shirt. It's just kind of hangs and just does that thing. And these just kind of do their thing. And I like it. So I got it. This is one of my shirts. It's $2.35. Now, you can't pass up a nice t-shirt that's, you know, in pretty good shape. So this is such a cool color. So I grabbed a t-shirt as well to wear under something. Not really, that doesn't really go. But I did find this, a really cute sweater. Another thing I never would have bought. I mean, I would never have given that a second. T-shirt, yes. Prefer V-necks, but I can go with this. But I found this, I grabbed this after I grabbed the sweater, because that is the coolest sweater. And it's by Olive and Oak, and I'm not familiar with them, and I don't know, I can look them up, see what I can find. And this is by Andy, I don't know what this says, and E-A-W-Y, A period, A dot, N dot, D, wow, I don't even know, but it's, it makes, you know, kind of, I don't know, doesn't really match much, you know what I'm saying, just kind of goes. But I had a black tank top when I was trying this on. It looked really good. Just wear it with the tank top. So, it worked. So, found that little thing. And then I grabbed this, and once again, just kind of interesting. And I thought, hey, I love the color. And it's by Coldwater Creek. And I like Coldwater Creek brands. And so, I just think this is a cool color. So, I grabbed it. I could work in it. Oh, today, by the way, we started oil painting, and I had on this. And this is not something I want to get oil paint on. I would rather wear my scrubs. I got to wear scrubs tomorrow. So yes, $2.35. Yeah, we're working on portraits. So that's the thing. This is the weirdest outfit. I don't know if you can see the link. Can I got the whole length in the picture? Yeah, pretty much. It's a two-way kind of dress more than a shirt. I don't even know what it's made. It has no tags whatsoever, which makes me, it's a 2XL too, which makes me think it's from China. It's just one of those, somebody ordered from China and bought it, and it, no way it fit, and I just got it because I am pretty sure it's from China. It feels like it's supposed to be a linen, or maybe they sold it like a linen, and it's cotton, but it definitely has a rayon to it. I can feel, you know, rayon, cotton rayon blend, if there's such a thing, or polyester rayon blend, probably. Yeah, no directions on how to wash it, but it's got cool pockets. And with the scarf, oh, I am gonna change these buttons out. Those buttons are so ugly. Or just wear it with a scarf. Because that color, horrible on me, but you know. And then I found this, and I have friends who've had the cabbie parties, you know, C-A-B-I. cabbie. They have those home parties, and I've been to them, and I've seen their stuff, and so I was familiar with the brand. But yeah, this is a little big for me. I think it's an extra large. Let me see, what is it? No, it's large. Actually, just a big. I guess it's just the way it's made then. So it's super long. It has these long things. And you know what? Are these bat wings still in style? I don't know, and I don't care, because I just thought it was kind of cool. So yeah, good thing to wear. So that was fun, and while I was there, and while I've got... Anyway, it's a dark gray. It's not really black. It's more dark gray. So, that was fun. Fun clothes. Need some clothes. I did hit the jewelry. This was $3. Oh, come on. It's two bracelets. And these are those stones. They're really, really nice. That real neutral color stone. So, I was pretty happy with that. And decided, yeah, I'm going to get those. And then I got these glass beads, and these are from the $2 bin. I mean, they're hanging, the $2 rack. And that's their new thing where they just put $2 on a lot of their jewelry, they just put $2 on. Now, if I was a bad person, I could have taken the price tag off of that. They may need to rethink that. Somebody could just, you know, get a nice necklace and take the tag off. Don't get any ideas, because don't be evil. Who would steal from a church-run organization? Boy, there's a whole nother hell for those people. Just saying. Anyway, I just love the, I always get this wrong, but I think it's called lamp wick or some weird name, or it's glass, but they're the crazy little glass. I will probably restring this, like I keep saying I'm going to do, and I never do. But I can wear it as a bracelet until then. Now, this was gold, but it caught my eye, and I said, I'm getting it. Because I think I have some gold earrings that they're kind of cute, may go with it. But I just love the stone. And what caught my eye was this little tiger eye. Because I do like me some tiger eye. It has a little piece of that. And then it has some more beads made out of that. And then this weird bead that looks like petrified wood, I guess. I don't know. And then the broken oyster shell type things. I do. I liked it. So that's kind of cute. Got some bling. Yeah, so I did good as far as that goes. But I hit the Barbies. Yes, I did. And I got, this is the Made to Move Barbie. Paid 75 cents for, but she's a hot mess. She's got marks on her face. I hope will come off. If not, you know, try the zit cream. I'll try all those things. She does need a serious bath. Lots of some, like, grungy marks on her legs. I'm telling you, these dolls are in terrible shape. But this I had to pay whole $1.25 for, because she's wearing a dress. But I do love the ones with the big feet. And I just bought another doll with big feet, so I thought, hey, I'll put those up together. This is one of my favorite faces. I think it's really cool. And so, it focuses. She's really pretty. I don't know who she is. I call her Summer. I don't know if that's her, if that is who she is, but that's what I call her. Now, this is a really interesting find. I found this. This is called a Golden Guide Seashells of the World. And this one's in pretty bad shape. But I got it anyway. Because these little books, if you've ever seen them, grab them. If you find one of these, just buy it, because they're adorable. But they're by Herbert S. Zim, who's PhD, SCD. I guess that's a science doctor. I don't know what a CD means. I actually met him when I was a little girl. Like, second grade, or maybe younger than that, very young. But I did meet him, and he was a friend, I think, of our aunt and uncle. But somehow we met him. I think we went to his house. I was really young. No, my sister, she was 11, so yeah, about 7. Yeah, that works out. So yeah, my sister remembers it better than I do, of course, because she was older. But when we went to see the man who helped write that or puts these together, usually with other people, this is the book I got. And this is the one, you know, for birds. And so I've had this book since I was about 7. So 50 years. Yeah, a little over 50. I'm about 50. Picture me 52 years over when I got it. Yeah, I'm getting old. Anyway, I also was able to find the old, this is the old trees. I'm sorry, this is flowers. This was flowers. And by the price, like this one was $1. So this was actually probably older than mine, because mine was $1.25. And when I bought flowers, I also found trees at the same little, you know, thrift store kind of thing. But I just love the illustrations in here, because they're painted. They're just precious. And I remember, I haven't looked at these two. I used to know a lot of trees. I should learn about my trees. But I just kept these three together for years in a box. And this is my box. The box these go in. So that's where they go. They live in this box. And I like to use that box for other decoration. But I just know they're in there and it makes me happy. But, so yeah, I got the seashells, which was, this was $2 originally. Ew, it's really dirty. $2.99 or 95 cents. I don't know. I'm hoping I can just clean that up real simple. It's got like a coffee stain or something on it. So I'm hoping I can clean it up. But yeah, they're tiny books. Isn't that, that's just so adorable. Look at that. So it's funny when my sister goes, oh, here, you got to get this. You got to, anytime you see these books, grab them. So I, it was for sale. At Goodwill for 50 cents, but I bought it at Rolling Hills for 50 cents. But the she says, grab these, and this one's not in great shape. But apparently, there's more. I haven't looked them up. If I have time before I post this video, I'll look them up and enter the names here. So, but birds, I'm sure there's animals. And come on, no, wait, did I see the animals one time? Somebody else had? Maybe Gina has it. I don't know. Seems like I've seen some like animals of North America or South America, whatever. I'll look them up. Okay, so going up to the checkout, someone had put this down, like, you know, this was not in the book section. It was like over, like when you get in line for the paper stuff. They didn't want to put it all the way back, so they just set it on the shelf. I was so excited. I was meant to have this book. Now, their books, I think the hardbacks, maybe $1 or $2. At some point I did post what their prices were. I forgot what it was. I don't care because I like it. So yeah, this is just a sweet little book, and this is another one that's going to go, I hate to look at it too much because I want to save it for the lake, but these are the kind of things I like to have at my lake house. It's another one of those flea market finds. If you, my previous video that I did, I found a magazine on flea market decorating, because that's how I decorate. So there. And then I found this, and it says Louisiana Through My Lens, photography by Chad Guidry. I don't know Chad personally, but it's really cute, and it's my area of Louisiana. This thing, oh my gosh, $35. Originally, of course, I paid like $1. But it's funny because I take all these pictures. This looks like Darbum Lake, which is not too far from me because I know they're having, but this is called Sandy Cove. I don't know where that is. But yeah, they have a problem with that. And look, Salvinia, people, the Salvinia. We hate it. It's killing us. It's really killing. I live, my lake house is at Lake Bistineau, which we call Lake Bistinot, because it's can't really enjoy it because of all the Salvinia. But they do drain it, and we're trying our best to do something with it. Lake Bossy Point. I don't know where that is. But I guess they traveled around Louisiana. And, And they even take pictures of like little houses and stuff. So this is going to be great for the lake. Yay. Well, that's it. That was me, hopefully for the week. I am trying to do so much better. And I will say, I will go shopping. I will put stuff in my cart and I'll give it a ride. And I've been much better about that and then putting it back. Thank goodness, because I have no more room for anything. Hey, so before I wrap this up, I wanted to show you my furniture I forgot I got this past week. What day did we pick this up or get it? I think I bought it last Monday, but I mean, told the lady I wanted it, and we picked up a couple of pieces, and then it was raining for days, and then they actually brought us the other pieces. So the look I'm going for in my house now is this Mission Oak. This, you know, kind of arts and crafts look. I just realized that drawer needs to be over there. Man, they can't figure it out. Yeah, that weird look. So that drawer, and then those two. Yep, that's probably had some sun hitting this side. I don't know. But yeah, I got this adorable, really nice set of bedroom furniture. Now, it did not have the bed that went with it, but we have a bed right now. And it had two of these nightstands. That's just a lamp that I painted a long time ago. And we have it in there. And so I have it. And then there's another. The end pieces are great. I mean, the nightstands, they are amazing to have that kind of storage. So that's pretty cool. Right. If you haven't seen this before, it was in my dining area and it's full of my dining kind of placemats, candles, and a bunch of stuff like that I use in my dining room. So we took it out and we brought it into my office because I was looking for something to go behind the door. And I even brought my little kitty from the wall as well.
So I got that, and that gives me the space I need in here, but there's more. So I brought the big old chest of drawers in here, and it is huge, but it goes with my TV stand over here. I also have the Mission Cell bookcases and things like that. We've kind of been just working that into our decor. And then, of course, I have this, when I bought this oak, a big old oak cabinet. Yeah, so this is like, this is Facebook Marketplace. This is how I decorate. And these are my precious cats. I love my cats. They're so much fun. Okay, so this is what I was talking about. This is our thing that we need to do. They have the plastic glides, and they're broken. So we had to get new ones. Yay!
I had fun. I saw a couple of people I knew, and that's always good. And it's like, hey, I knew my sister. And yeah, I forgot to introduce her because I don't know anyone's name. I have nominal aphasia, and I totally forget people's name, especially when I'm like face-to-face. I will forget my sister's name if I try to introduce her. So there was that. Well, I will tell you this. I am going to be doing no Facebook February, and I just need a break. And that's my new goal. And I've been pretty good about my other goals, about not shopping or not spending or what, or getting, you know, making money some other way to spend money versus just spending money. So I'm hoping that's I can get through the month of February, no Facebook. Now I do have people who message me, and I do feel like I should respond to messages, but I will tell them don't you know. I'm doing hashtag no Facebook February, and hopefully I can get through the whole month. Yeah, I'm just really frustrated with everything in the world right now, and I just don't need it in my face because I know it's out there, and I know if I want it I can find it somewhere. I just, Facebook is not the place I want to see it. I have enjoyed Facebook for years because I like to see what my friends are up to, and I like to see what the funny videos and things that they share and stuff like that, and funny little jokes. But it just became so political that I'm done with that. I don't need to see that anymore. I just need to find a happy place. And so that's what I'm doing. Probably not only no Facebook February. Let's see if I can just kick it off where I'm just ready to be done with Facebook. Sorry. But yeah, still doing YouTube because, well, I committed to this maybe a little bit longer to see how it goes. But anyway, thanks for watching. And hit the like button. Subscribe if you haven't, and share and with your friends. And this is not one of my best videos, I know, but hey, it's something I did. And I'm trying to keep this up every Thursday. So thanks for watching. Bye.